Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Dr. Graham K. Blount.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It's a special and personal privilege to be invited back 25 years after the first time for reflection. 25 years on seems a good time to reflect. And what a day to do it on. A day to remember. A foiled, faith-based terrorist attack on a parliament. A disturbing thought for today. Halfway between Guy Fawkes and today, that parliament had a major accidental fire. As the Westminster building was rebuilt, there was a competition for artists to submit paintings fit for the new building. One of these has recently gone on display at the National Gallery here. It is called Christ Teacheth Humility, and it wasn't accepted. Officially, they didn't like its luscious colours. But I wonder if its theme didn't fit any more than it might fit in a church pulpit 6 feet above contradiction. There's a lot going on in that painting. Jesus' followers are embarrassed, having been caught jockeying for position. Some seem uncertain at what their leader is saying. Others are so enthusiastic, they might be banging their desks if they had any. The opposition are horrified at the nonsense he's talking, and some are hatching a plot to get rid of him. Clearly, all this didn't fit in a parliament. And anyway, the backdrop is described as distinctively Scottish. Although the artist's spotlight is on Jesus, he's pointing not to himself, but to a wee child, shifting the focus from himself to someone that everyone else seems to ignore, a crazy upside-down way of thinking who's important. Humility rightly gets a bad name when it's urged by powerful folk on others to know their place. Here, it's an invitation to get beyond any sense that we know best, that my church or my party has a monopoly on truth or righteousness. It's an encouragement to listen carefully beyond the loudest voices, beyond those with most to say for themselves. Could these be echoes of the hopes and dreams and visions we had for this place 25 years ago? I believe they are still alive here and outside. May you, may we, with God, continue to do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly. Oh, and there's one other thing in the picture. A grumpy-looking old man on the fringe, more in the distinctly Scottish backdrop, seemingly unsure what to make of it all. I'm worried. He might be me. Ask my granddaughter. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Blount. Thank you.
Thank you.